The Sumerians were an ancient hybrid civilization founded upon Earth by a secretive bloodline of fallen angel beings known as the Anunnaki. The children of the Anunnaki are called the Nephilim. These half-human, half-fallen angel children were giants. Their existence is a result of unnatural sexual relations between themselves and some of the weaker-minded women of our early Earth. The Anunnaki alien demons taught the mortals magic and forbidden practices only known of in the heavens. These mortal women were, and still are, hidden amongst us in a secretive society or order of witches and spiritualistic practicing psychics. They learned all these herbal and spiritual manipulations and practices from the fallen angels that came to Earth shortly after the rebellion in Eden. These women were originally some of the children of Cain spoken of in the Bible, Book of Genesis. Cain was Earth's first murderer, as jealousy caused him to strike down his brother Abel. These Nephilims were also secretively known of as the Mayans. They were secretively also the Roman soldiers whom pierced Christ. The revelations predicted those Roman soldiers would reincarnate and be alive once again to see the epic return or coming of Jesus Christ. Jesus said in Revelations, quote, I am the Alpha and the Omega, I am coming again, and every eye will see me, even those who pierced me, end quote. These Nephilims who pierced Christ were also secretively the Egyptians whom constructed the pyramids in Egypt. They were also the founders and architects of the lost civilization of Atlantis. They were also not so secretively amongst those destroyed by God in the two cities of Sodom and Gomorrah described of in the Bible. Their hybrid half-human children were also known of after the great Mosaic flood as the Canaanites. The Canaanites ruled over the fabled land of milk and honey, and according to Israelite spies, they were a giant people that caused the Israelite spies to feel as mere grasshoppers in the eyes of the Canaanite giants. The Israelites never were able to enter into and overthrow that fabled land of milk and honey, due to their lack of faith in Almighty God. These Canaanites were also post-flood Nephilims. As a result of these demonic giants, God brought the great Mosaic flood recorded in the Bible, Book of Genesis. Over the centuries, since the flood of Noah's day, these Nephilims disembody at death and are considered demons or ghosts while in transition. These spirits eventually reincarnate into their bloodline once again. This is how they have gained and maintained worldly power, riches and dominance of industry, governments and land. Jesus said, quote, the whole world is lying in the power of the wicked one, end quote. Over the centuries, through their human child sacrificing of most all of their oddball giant, six-finger, large-headed horned babies, they have culled and manipulated themselves into a hidden secret society or bloodline that cannot easily be identified outwardly. They have bred into themselves secretive abilities to hear frequencies and backlash music as a way to congregate and pass information secretly. They dominate all professional fields such as law enforcement, science, and every other field, whether it be medical, technological, archaeological or otherwise. You name it, they control the strings of every industry imaginable, including all aspects of information and government. World leaders from around the planet congregate and celebrate their rise to world power and dominance in a ritualistic mock human child sacrifice to their giant horned Canaanite deity Molech. Most noteworthily, at the Bohemian Grove in California, where presidents of our own country attend. Google Bohemian Grove. They currently are amongst us today, secretively ruling most of Earth's governments, corporations, organizations and churches that we patronize daily, both minor and megalithic in nature. They are secretively watching this video, and live and work amongst us and hide behind flags and idols like the cross as a cloak. They hate these truths. Every time their satanic secret society climbs to prominence too quickly, Almighty God brings them down, as he is about to do once again in our day during a time known of and foretold throughout the Bible and most recently by Christ as the Great Tribulation followed by Armageddon. He confused their language in Babel. Nimrod tried building a tower to the heavens to proclaim his power. Thus the term, babbling idiots, was born, as their babbling new languages caused them to stop building the famed Tower of Babel. Babylon is located in modern-day Iraq. The Sumerians were also founded in ancient Babylon, now known as Iraq. The Tower of Babel was being constructed 4,000 years before the coming of Jesus Christ, or roughly 6,011 years ago. The Mayan calendar ends in 2012 because the 3,600-year cycle of their Anunnaki planet comes near Earth in closest proximity again in December 2012. 12 is Nephilim midnight. They know this because their giant Anunnaki fallen angel forefathers were temporarily here 3,600 years ago. The rogue planet these fallen angels inhabit is called Nibiru. Watch the video I have posted on my page in the video download section called Egypt, Atlantis, USA Freemason Illuminati Bloodlines. I did not create that video, and it's not quite right because the Anunnaki, Illuminati, Nephilims are twisting and tainting history so that the part about them being fallen angels and the truth about Almighty God and the Bible is left out of history altogether. Satan is the master of deceit and slander. Both the names Satan and devil literally mean deceiver and slanderer. One cannot be taught or convinced about the true and full facts that are rapidly unfolding in this epic and long-awaited historical time of the end until first they wrap their mind around and fully digest and accept the grand and glorious picture about what is really coming upon this world's satanically controlled society. Only once one accepts the true and literal nature of the Bible's version of creation and of the fallen Anunnaki angels along with their hybrid Nephilim's children can they then begin to climb out of the spiritual darkness of the forest trees and finally see with clarity and enlightenment the greater horizon and grand picture from up above this world's suffocating darkness. It's true. This world is secretly being controlled and ran in all facets by a well-established, well-organized and extremely extensive and well-oiled bloodline conspiracy machine of death. Their ultimate goal is to seize control of the entire Earth and then dominate and control it with their New World Order satanic society without the need for secrecy. They then seek to enslave and destroy humanity of non-demonic bloodlines. Note, the Anunnaki and Nephilims are extensively exposed in the Book of Enoch, a pre-Noah document. Most humans are blind, wandering around thinking the world is random. Like fools wandering in a football stadium, having no idea that it's a game, people have seats and plans and understanding of what's going on. Many wander on the field lost thinking everyone's lost. Wake up and find truth over time. Digest this, and if you begin to comprehend the possibility that science, archaeology, news, governments, music, television, school systems are a monopoly of Nephilims and witches that want to come out of secrecy and own everything and not need money, just slaves. The Illuminati Nephilims have perpetrated the assassinations of John F. Kennedy, Martin Luther King, Elvis Presley, Howard Hughes, Malcolm X, John Lennon, Michael Jackson, Tupac Shakur and many others. They overwhelm control and secretively try and control and inherit money into their secret hidden society of half-breed humans that are ultimately married to their cause. They are also responsible for the 9/11 attack on the Twin Towers. They are in a mad dash to control and unite all governments under the disguise of the New World Order. They eliminate or kill most anyone in music industry that rebels against their secret order or attempts to alert the masses or preach a kill Illuminati philosophy. In these final days, they are overwhelmed by mass awakening and are in a damage control mode. Pray for understanding and truth. Forget religion. Pray to Almighty God. Watch some of my videos and try to understand the big picture. God bless the peaceable.
No eternal reward will forgive us now for wasting the dawn.